What if you could see all the pollution around you? What if carbon dioxide, instead of being clear, were a dirty yellow color? And even better, maybe it had a little tag on it that told you exactly where it came from. Well, thanks to the wonders of modern technology, we're going to be able to do that for you as soon as next year. And to explain that, I need an analogy. And to explain that analogy, I need to know all the ice hockey fans in the audience. There's three of you. It's great. Not much overlap between TEDx San Diego and ice hockey fans. I'm Australian. Everything I knew about ice hockey, I learned from Rodney Dangerfield. You know, I went to a fight and the ice hockey game broke out. This is what it's going to look like. This yellow stuff is really a scientific measurement of carbon dioxide over Los Angeles and San Diego. And I'm going to quickly explain to you how you figure out not only how much carbon dioxide there is, but where it's come from. So there are two aspects to this. One is you need to be able to measure carbon dioxide. Well, we're in the right place. Just a few miles away from here at Scripps Oceanography, Charles David Keeling figured out how to do that in 1958. And for 54 years, he and his son, Ralph Keeling, have been measuring every month the carbon dioxide concentration at Mauna Loa in Hawaii and also at the South Pole. And those little annual wiggles there you can see are what nature does. That's the breathing of the Northern Hemisphere. That's the growing of leaves in the summer and the spring and the leaves falling to the ground and decaying during the fall and the winter. The rest of it is us. The rest of it is burning fossil fuel. And we've added, since the Industrial Revolution, 40% more CO2 than nature put here. So we know how to make these measurements. But in order to figure out where the CO2 has come from, we have to make a lot of measurements. And normally, we would try and do this with the governments of the world. But I don't know if you've noticed, the governments aren't doing that much anymore. So Scripps decided to team up with a private company, a company that changed its name to Earth Networks. Behind this technology, of course, it's really all about the people. And here are three key people: Bob Marshall, the CEO of Earth Networks; Ralph Keeling in the top panel; and Ray Weiss. Ray's an expert in measuring all the other greenhouse gases other than CO2. And on the left-hand side is a little company from Silicon Valley, Picaro, that made instruments that are accurate enough and cheap enough to make all these measurements. So here's how it works. You put 50 of these devices over the United States. And on this map are where those 50 devices are going to be. The color coding is there's three green circles here, and these are the ones that are operating. And you can actually see them online at earthnetworks.com. One of the little green circles on the left there is on the Scripps Pier, just a couple of miles from here. The others are near the Earth Networks headquarters in Maryland. The red dots are where we've already signed leases for tall towers, so we have power and Ethernet to get the data out. And the white ones are still people we're negotiating with. These are the kind of boxes that sit there. There's all kinds of fun toys for us to play with at each one of these sites. So here again is what CO2 looks like. And now let me explain to you how we figure out where it's coming from. All you need to know is the weather. Actually, you just need to know the weather backwards. So every little molecule that we breathe has come from somewhere. It might have come from Tijuana, it might have come from Los Angeles, it might have come from South Korea, or it might have come from Oregon. Well, we know so much about the weather these days that we can actually run the weather programs, the ones that give us pretty good predictions in 5 days, we can run them even more accurately backwards for up to 10 days, so we know exactly where the air is coming from. So imagine we put a little boundary around California and follow all the molecules of pollution that come, all that evil CO2 that Oregon is making, all of the benign CO2 we're handing over to Reno and Las Vegas and Arizona. We do all the puts and takes and add it up, and we know exactly how much CO2 everybody's making. Well, we hope we're going to change the dynamic of the climate change debate by giving you and everybody the opportunity to know not only how much CO2 and methane you're breathing, but where it's coming from. Let me show you a little story. This is the CO2 at Mauna Loa. The red line is the CO2 at the South Pole. The difference between them is how much CO2 is moving from the Northern Hemisphere to the Southern Hemisphere. You see that it's increasing? I'm from the Southern Hemisphere. We love you. But don't be surprised someday if we say, thanks for the iPhone, thanks for the Rolling Stones, but keep the CO2. Thank you.